How will you convince senior citizens that Social Security and Medicare need to be changed and get their vote?
The first question may have been on Social Security, but it was really about Rick Perry, who once called the program a Ponzi scheme.
It has been called a Ponzi scheme by many people long before me. But no one's had the courage to stand up and say, here is how we're going to reform it.
But as Perry tried to turn down the heat, Mitt Romney cranked it up.
But the question is, do you still believe that Social Security should be ended as a federal program, as you did 6 months ago when your book came out, and return to the states? Or do you want to retreat from that?
I think we ought to have a conversation.
We're having that right now, Governor.
I'll finish this conversation.
That teed up what might have been the one-liner of the night.
I'm not particularly worried about Governor Perry and Governor Romney frightening the American people when President Obama scares them every single day.
But that wasn't the only flashpoint. Take the economy. Asked whether the Lone Star governor was responsible for jobs created in his home state, Romney said pro-business Texas deserved the credit, not Perry.
Go ahead and tell him how much credit he deserves.
Well, yeah. Well look, I think Governor Perry would agree with me that if you're dealt four aces, that doesn't make you necessarily a great poker player.
Well, I was going to say, Mitch, you were doing pretty good till you got to talking poker.
But it was Michelle Bachmann who was coming up with some winning hands, hitting Perry on his executive order to require that schoolgirls receive vaccinations against the sexually transmitted HPV virus that may cause cervical cancer.
Little girls who have a negative reaction to this potentially dangerous drug don't get a mulligan. They don't get a do-over.
Then she suggested Perry was interested in doing more than saving lives.
I just wanted to add that we cannot forget that in the midst of this executive order, there was a big drug company that made millions of dollars because of this mandate. We can't deny that.
You got to respond to that.
Yes, sir. The company was Merck, and it was a $5,000 contribution that I had received from them. I raise about $30 million. And if you're saying that I can be bought for $5,000, I'm offended.
And Perry found himself on the wrong side of the Tea Party when he defended his support for in-state college tuition for the children of illegal immigrants, a policy that got boos from the crowd.
Have you?
That is not the American way.